Hey everyone, what's going on? Greg here again from Team Blast. I want to go over Microsoft Bing Webmaster Tools and the way that I use it for myself and for my clients' websites. I'm on the Home tab, click on View Complete Report. This is very similar to Google Search Console. You can change the filter by web and chat or news. Just for me, have it all as the setting. Next, scroll all the way down. Here are your keywords. These are the sample keywords driving impressions and clicks. Remember, Bing powers Bing.com, Yahoo, AOL, DuckDuckGo, Ecosia, and a few other search engines as well. So this is just, you know, combinations of all of them. Now you can keep clicking on clicks. This is going to bring sample data here. What I encourage you to do is use a tool like SEMrush, set up daily keyword tracking for the non-brand terms that are most important for your business, just to get an idea of how your rankings are within Bing. Next, go to the pages report. Again, I like to look at this because if I'm looking for ways to increase visibility for my clients or even for my own website, I look at the pages report. Here I can see 1,500 impressions over the past 3 months have been happening for my NY local SEO page. If I hover over this, it's actually going to load the page. So what I want to do is move my mouse a little bit to the right and then click on it. This is going to show you the keywords now ranking for this page. What I recommend again is to maybe export out this information, put into Excel or Google Sheets, whatever you want to use, and just get an idea from the average rank position, the impressions, and then again, you put those keywords into SEMrush, set up daily keyword tracking. Now you have an idea of kind of what to focus on from a Bing traffic perspective. Next, go to Site Explorer. I find this actually be really helpful. Sometimes people reach out to me for an SEO audit, or when I work on their account for the first month, I like to look at their Bing Site Explorer because they might say, hey, I'm only getting 3% of my traffic from Bing. It's not worth it. I've gone in here. I've actually filtered by things like guideline issues, other issues, and no index tags. And believe it or not, that actually does come up. There are some issues that people just don't recognize. If you don't have an SEO crawler tool, you might not even notice there's no index tag on a few pages or canonical tag problems. Bing will actually show me those problems. If I can fix that, it will also help your Google traffic, but also it will help grow your Bing traffic as well. So great way to look at this. And then real quick, the way this works is that you can click on this arrow. I'm going to go to services and click on NYC local SEO. That's fine. You can see on the right-hand side, it's indexed. It has, you know, here's the impressions. Last crawled was August 18th. And then I can inspect the URL. I can block the URL, request indexing, test URL, new robots.txt. A lot of this is just technical stuff, but this is so important because, again, if you're not driving a lot of traffic to your website, use the Site Explorer tool, see if there's any problems with that. Now, next is your sitemap. So this is very similar to Google Search Console. I have a generic sitemap underscore index.xml. And that has page and post because I have a WordPress website. So it's just good for me to see exactly last time that they were crawled. You can see that the post has not. And that's actually interesting because I haven't really posted any new blogs in many months. But the pages itself, though, that has been last crawled, as you can see, on 8/26. Now, I don't have this feature for myself. None of my clients actually do either. But I've seen this on SEO Roundtable and Search Engine Journal and LAN. Anyway, Index Now is great. If you have like a large content website, you might want to do this because if you make any changes, let's say you update it with like an updated paragraph and then it says updated on whatever day, you can have Bing kind of see that change and then crawl it. So if you have a large website, e-commerce or content website, maybe I would encourage you to have this for my website. It's not a lot that changes on a day-to-day, so that's why I don't have that checked off. URL submission over here. So what I like about this is that you can actually put in, so if you go to the URL inspection, you can inspect an individual URL, and then you can actually force Bing to re-crawl and re-index it. So if you make a change to your website, you don't have an index now, you want to use URL submission because, again, you might make a change or you might publish a page. It might take Bing, let's take a week to find that page naturally. You can force them to crawl that page, get seen faster, and get rankings faster than simply just waiting for that. Backlinks are important. I don't know which search engine cares more about backlinks or not, but the point though is that Google Search Console and Bing Webmaster Tools have a backlinks feature. So it tells me that it does have some value. What I like to do here is you can go to, let's say for me, trustindex.io, I can click on this and I can see exactly all the different versions of the page that then link out to TM Blast. I can see the anchor text and I can see the target page. If I go back to it, you can also change it to the pages of what are getting the most, where the source URL is linking out. And then finally, you can go to the anchor text section. You can get an idea. Okay, so tmblast.com, visit website, website TM Blast, et cetera. This is actually pretty important. I haven't come across this with my own clients that I have, but essentially though, if you had some very strange anchor text, let's say it was very keyword specific, that might be an example of maybe you were buying links or anything that might be a little unnatural. So when you say your brand name is kind of linked out, then that's very natural. But if you came across, if you saw terms like best SEO, SEO expert, SEO company, NYCSC or NYC, you know, local SEO, that would probably raise kind of a flag to Bing. But this looks a pretty natural backlink opportunity or backlink profile. Keyword research. So this is what I find, again, is that if you're, you know, struggling to grow your Bing traffic, check this out. So you can put in a term like, let's say, local SEO. I'm going to hit enter. This is going to show me the last few months, all countries over here. I'm going to click on just United States. It's going to change the map again. And then what I like to do is you can actually scroll down here and see. So top SEO companies for small business, that trend is pretty consistent. You have other terms too. If you keep scrolling all the way down, it says the top 10 URL rankings on this keyword. This is actually pretty neat too. So again, I'm looking at the term local SEO and I can get an idea of who is ranking on page one for Bing. This is just a good way to kind of get an idea. So most of the time, Google and Bing are going to be, you know, pretty similar with what are the primary keywords to go after. But again, if you are struggling to grow your Bing traffic, maybe play around with the keyword research tool and see what terms are more prevalent on Bing and Yahoo and AOL and DuckDuckGo than they are on Google. Plus two, you might even come across terms that can be applicable to also Google as well. So you can add that to your term. In fact, even for TM Blast, I saw the term was, I think it was local SEO marketing or some combination of that. They came from the keyword planner tool. And I didn't even think about that term. So I added that into my keyword daily tracking for Google and Bing. I see if I can grow that. Now, if you go over here, so I think it's top insights. Yeah. At a very high level, if you're new to SEO, Bing has a great top insights report. They'll tell you things that are high severity all the way down to low. So if you are new to SEO and you're trying to learn about, you know, title tags, image alt tags, anything like that, this is the report for you. So for example, if I click into this, this image does not have an alt tag. It'll actually tell you exactly what that even means. And then it's gonna show you what pages don't have one of the images that doesn't have the image alt tag. So it is helpful. Again, this is pretty basic, but if you're new to SEO, check out the top insights tab. Again, if there's a lot of errors within your account, and you fix them, that'll be a great way to kind of increase your traffic from Bing. Last but not least, configuration. So I like to do the crawl control for all of my clients. So for me, I'm going to have it just set to highest. The reason why is because I went through a site migration. So I'm trying to force now Bing to heavily crawl my websites as fast and as hard as they can, because the way you can have it set to is, you can see, you can change it to, let's say, your off hours. So you can say, hey, crawl the site from 5 o'clock to 11 o'clock. And then during the day, have less. Most websites don't have to worry about this because, again, if you're a very heavy, intense website with a lot of, you know, hundreds of thousands of visits coming to it, you want to have Bing crawl your website during the non-peak hours, because you don't want them to potentially, Bing bot to slow down the website as they crawl. So you want to flip it. But for most websites, you know, the ones that I manage, for example, you don't have to worry too much about, you know, Bing slowing down your website. And this is like for the very top websites that get hundreds and hundreds of thousands of visits. You might want to play around with that. And then last but not least, they have the section over here. It says security and privacy copyright removal notices. Again, this is a good suggestion. If there's any issues within Bing search results, you can find that. That'll be listed down here. There's other things down here too, like Microsoft Clarity. I'm not going to go into that, but that's just a way to get some heat tracking for your website. So if you're into that, you can add the script. It is interesting, but from my experience, it does kind of slow down your website. So I would encourage you maybe do it just for it as like a test, you know, like 1 or 2 week, you know, grab some data. But I wouldn't leave it on just because sometimes you leave it on, you forget about it, and then you have this legacy code that slows down your website. Anyway, though, that's it in a nutshell. When it comes to Bing for all my clients in 2024, including my own website, it's about 13% of my total SEO traffic. So Bing is important. And I like to look at Bing Webmaster Tools just to get an idea if there's any issues with BingBot crawling a website, if there's any issues with their crawling and indexing content, you know, some keyword opportunities, the backlinks pointing to it. It's actually, and I mean, for me, I don't really care too much about the site scan because I'm a little bit more advanced than just the basic technical issues that might come up. But again, if you're new to SEO and you're trying to find ways to grow your traffic, definitely check that out. Anyway, I hope this video was interesting and helpful. I'd love to know if you guys use Bing Webmaster Tools and what your favorite feature is. Let me know in the comment section. Thanks again for watching. And as always, have a good rest of your day.